wilds loud.
It's intense.
Josh, let's skip the fake-out intro this time. It's way too freaking long.
Fine.
Oh, this was made by a committee of people who've never met in real life.
Alright.
See, it's funny because they skipped the fake-out intro by doing a fake-out intro. We call that irony in literary circles.
Top 10 saddest video game moments. Number 10, Dynasty Warriors. A laughing autarch production? What?
You know, color on color is hard to read enough, but flames on flames? That's new.
Video games have been endlessly debated as to whether or not they're a new art form. Certainly like art, video games have been shown to be able to stir up emotions in us.
Like Super Paper Mario!
And
I got so emotional. Frustration and boredom is an emotion, right?
When
yeah.
When you're playing a character in a virtual world, it almost feels as if you've become part of the game's drama. And so when something depressing happens in a video game, it can pack quite an emotional punch, especially with more real-life issues being applied to video
my
games.
My head grows five times its normal size.
More traumatic experiences like death.
My skin is so smooth and poreless.
By the complexity that video games offer.
So we're here today to pay tribute to
a sad moment where Dante's hand gets nicked.
In this list, we're basing our choices based off how close they were to making us tear up. So if you're
but we never actually would. We're like real men.
That you have a Kleenex box on standby. Also, for a list about sad moments, this should go without saying. Spoilers are all over the place.
I'd love to see, like, a spoiler-free version of this. Okay, in this game, there's this one thing, and trust me,
it's so sad!
Weeping. I can't tell you any more than that, but you'll know it when you get there.
So what do you think number 10's gonna be?
I hope it's nothing to do with Kingdom Hearts.
They've already showed a lot of Kingdom Hearts, and they've used mostly Kingdom Hearts music, so I'm expecting Kingdom Hearts to be somewhere.
I'm expecting this to be a fake out, and it's just like something else, and they save Kingdom Hearts
There's
for later.
Sonic!
One thing that irritates me to no end about the 3D Sonic games, it's their characters. Most of them are one-dimensional.
I'm really just
annoying,
asking for more character development with Eggman.
Yes, we get it. We know what they freaking say.
Don't get traumatized yet. We aren't even at the first sad moment.
Yeah, we just have to interrupt ourselves to show that we can interrupt ourselves.
Games are uninteresting due to
how I'm amazed that this guy wants less of Sonic and Eggman when they are the best characters.
Who actually had great development in Sonic Adventure 2.
No!
Oh, yeah, you know.
Until they ruined him by reviving him, giving him guns.
Yeah, it wasn't until Shadow the Hedgehog that Shadow was ruined. Sonic Adventure 2, though, a masterpiece!
Gamma is a creation of Robotnik's that appears to have emotions. He becomes disturbed by Robotnik's treatment of his fellow E-Series robots, and also
I'm disturbed that he thinks he can walk forward into a barrier.
That Robotnik sent Gamma to abduct. These events lead him to shun his creator and attempt to free each of his brothers.
Eventually, he comes across his big brother, a heavily modified Beta, who Gamma heavily damages in battle. Out of sympathy, Gamma walks toward his brother, who promptly proceeds to shoot Gamma at point-blank range.
As Gamma lays on the ground malfunctioning, Beta explodes and reveals the bird inside him. Gamma connects the dots and realizes that Amy's bird and Beta's bird are...
That is a serious sentence that someone said about emotionally moving moments.
...explodes, releasing his own bird.
Picture this! You're a bird! Picture this! You're a robot with a bird inside you!
If this heart-wrenching family reunion isn't enough to make you choke up just a little?
Yeah, look at this heart-wrenching moment. Look at those birds.
The birds look pretty happy, actually.
This death really hit home for us because of how real a character Gamma seemed.
Don't even say...
robot.
If you quote...
We'll never forget
that... No, you're doing it! You're doing it!
You don't get to do that.
Human.
You can't. Let me guess, this is a joke and you're gonna say, nah, Final Fantasy's dumb, right? It's overrated, dudes.
No, no, these guys are way too sappy for that.
You know, in hindsight, Aerith's death isn't that
tragic. No, they did it.
Aerith?
For one, she was hardly
really?
Useful in
yeah,
battle.
Absolutely. It's the real translation!
Being an Arrowhead who pretty much existed to be a living plot device and a love interest for Cloud.
But anyway, we totally
not
bought
to
it,
mention,
so.
Cloud chewing the scenery over her corpse came.
Yeah, you can really chew up scenery when you're in a text box.
In contrast to Aerith's death, we had the death of Lavitz Slambert.
I love, Sephiroth just going woo in the background.
Psych, I got you! You did not see that coming!
The life of the king is certain.
So anyways, that JRPG was dumb, but this one's way sad. Look at this! A JRPG character died at the end of the first disc!
Game's first disc.
Yeah, I was right.
Part of the whole tragedy of this scene is that Lavitz was very likable. He was level-headed, selfless, and even a bit of a jokester.
And he looked like he was made of Legos, which are my favorite toys.
He acted much like Dart does, and was like the brother he never had. Plus, Lavitz is one of the strongest characters in the game, so his death is even more painful if you've devoted a lot of time to leveling him up.
After saving the king, Lavitz died.
Well, that's just you being petty and stupid,
yeah.
Isn't it? Like,
yeah.
Faces as they see Lavitz go limp really sell the whole poignancy of this depressing scene. These are completely realistic reactions.
Look at these completely realistic reactions, like screaming towards the sky. Lavitz!
Lavitz is just a portmanteau for Lenny Kravitz, right?
Yeah, actually.
Oh, okay.
Jack and Daxter, good.
Hey, what's up?
Until the third game. However, it's in the third game that Jack actually gains a bit of a father.
God, how do you make this game look so muddy?
A king that
what did you do?
They dropped the disc in mud, and this is what happened.
God. Legitimate care for Jack. He actually becomes sort of a father figure to Jack.
Yeah, you said that like 20 seconds ago.
Didn't your father ever tell you to pick your battles wisely?
I didn't know my father.
My point is, sometimes you face your enemy head on, and sometimes you wait. Until his weakness is revealed.
My weakness is JRPG deaths, especially after I spent a lot of time leveling that character up.
Yeah, pretty big tearjerker. I'm actually really surprised they're putting something that isn't a JRPG in this list. I was honestly expecting everything to either be Sonic or JRPGs.
Yeah, yeah, you know, Aeris, Kravitz, Fiora, just
whatever it's.
Was his own past self. That just adds 10 levels of intense right there.
Precisely 10 levels.
That Jax's son happened at pretty much the same time. So the magnitude of the sadness you feel at this point.
Let me just get out my sadness magnitude chart.
But then the emotions go from mere sadness to a mix of sadness and anger when Count Vulgar,
it's Vega,
whatever, reveals he was the one who took the child Jack from Damas, then proceeds to paint himself as an unbelievable prick by saying...
I'm learning a lot about Jack and Daxter.
Yeah, I don't know anything about Jack and Daxter.
You were the son of the great warrior Damas.
Well, now I never have to play three, at least.
How delightful.
What an asshole!
Really?
Oh, remember the 51st States video game? That was a tearjerker.
Remember all those games Adam Sandler was in? You know, like Wind Waker.
So much extra content in each game that it'll add on several hours to your game time.
I like that girl.
Side quests. The main side quest in Majora's Mask is an entire subplot. An entire romance subplot at that.
Whoa!
This is the Couples Mask quest, aka the Cafe Romance. And
you know, because they make out in a cafe.
This subplot is a massive tearjerker.
An old lady asks you to find her son, Cafe.
No, it's a time waster. That's not the same thing.
You come across
yeah, you just have to,
be,
like, wait until, like, a minute before the game ends, the world ends, whatever. And then it's like, hooray, you get the mask, and then you leave.
And then you cry all night.
All night? I guess I did. I forgot about me, you know, crying a lot.
Asking you to keep a secret, he reveals that he's actually Cafe. Let's just say that Kefi isn't exactly a lucky person. He was cursed by the Skull Kid to have an appearance of a child as a prank.
Oh man, that's horrible.
He had his ceremonial wedding mask stolen by a thief. Lately, he's been hiding from Anju out of complete shame. It's almost like losing her wedding ring right before the wedding.
On the last
oh no,
day,
this is a situation I can relate to!
Isn't that exactly what it is? Like, that's what the mask is used for.
Yeah.
The end of the world is near, and during
I lost all my money. It's kind of like not having $50.
What follows is a particularly powerful moment where you literally wait with Anju for
I think the worst thing about this video is just mainly the way these guys keep talking. They just won't speak normally.
No. They talk about how it's so powerful to literally sit and wait. Sitting and waiting is the most sad and powerful thing one can do.
I do this a lot, actually.
The Kaffee romance is an almost Shakespearean kind of depressing moment. Kaffee's been hit with setback after setback. Andrew's feeling depressed.
They just compared this to, like, Shakespeare. They said this was Shakespearean.
Oh, of course it is.
It is, yeah.
He has giant feet.
He has big feet, yeah.
Unless you use a song timer to rewind it 3 days. Yeah, yeah, I know.
Remember that book, you know, that play Shakespeare wrote? You know, where there's, like, an hour where everybody just stands still?
Yeah, and then they go back in time.
Yeah.
It was undoubtedly made for art's sake. In particular, the game has a deep message to it. The main character wants...
What is the deep message of Shadow of Colossus, pray tell?
There isn't?
Like, I want to see what these guys say it is.
...kill 16 giant creatures. Dorman even warns the impetuous Wanderer that the price he'd pay for these actions would be heavy.
But he does it anyway, what a dumb shit.
Where Wanderer starts suffering so much that you just want to hug the poor guy. Before he reached
well,
the process,
he never really looks like he's suffering. He just wakes up.
These are just touchy-feely dudes.
And then his face is like a little dirty. All right, maybe not hug him. Maybe give him like a towel.
Give him a good old slap on the back.
Yeah.
Filthy, alone, and throughout all this, you just feel that something isn't quite right. All these feelings of doubt.
You know, I really like Shadow of the Colossus, but it's not this poignant.
Still. Press on and
like, this part's really cool and atmospheric, but you're just not like, I don't know, this just isn't right. There's just something wrong about this. I just got a feeling.
Is as follows.
I mean, that would make you stop playing.
Yeah, and it's kind of like the opposite of what games want you to do.
This leads an elite guard led by Lord Emon to attack Wander with swords and arrows, very nearly killing him. As the possessed Wander falls, he reaches out to Mono, who is still dead. That's right. Your reward for killing the Colossi is that you get no reward. You trusted a demon, Wander, and now you pay with your life.
It's pretty poignant, I guess. I suppose the deep messages don't trust a demon?
Yeah, it's a good thing I had a video game teach me that. Otherwise, yeah. Whew, I would have been in a tight spot.
I mean, he's called a demon, but you can't judge them all just by, the, you know, what they're called. That'd be a nice demon.
Yeah.
Not only that, but
maybe he's just down on his luck, you know.
And Wander will never know about either of these things. After all, what's left of him is a horned infant.
The final act of Shadow of the Colossus is a powerful yet depressing moral fable about following authority and the consequences that come into play should one ever defy it. This whole ending is a huge punch to the player, essentially calling you out for trusting a demon with resurrecting a girl whose fate was already cursed to begin with. It's a really confusing ending at times. All of the
it's a pretty plain and simple ending.
Some people are being really confused right now. I'll agree. All,
but God.
In the end, we feel immense sympathy for him.
You know, I actually, they showed a whole bunch of random games in that intro, but I really hope Super Paper Mario's in this list somewhere.
I hope so.
Because I don't know what you could even say is sad in Super Paper Mario except Super Paper Mario!
Is a dark game.
Oh, yeah, totally.
So we all know about how creepy Mimi and Super Dementia are.
Yeah, Super
look
Dementia.
I'm shaking in my boots right now.
Subject matter. The main villain is a tragic villain. He's destroyed all worlds, and it's revealed later that he's doing this.
I am never gonna stop laughing.
It comes to
you know what's way sadder than characters dying and stuff?
Tippy used to be Count Black. They were known as
you know what's way sadder than Count Black? Anyone who thinks yeah, Count Black was sad.
Black after his own father banished Timpani to another realm to die. If he couldn't live with his love, then no one would live at all.
This already depressing backstory comes to fruition in the game's final chapter. When Black reforms and instead Dementio attempts to destroy all worlds, the love of Lumiere and Timpani is put to the ultimate test.
The ultimate test.
Forced marriage, in order to counter it,
can you really look at this script you wrote for yourself and say, yes, these words shall come from my mouth. I will be known for saying them.
Without the chaos,
this is a good idea.
Their link to the pure hearts will make them cease to exist.
Whoa.
After exchanging some heart-wrenching words at the altar, the two get married and disappear in a flash of light.
They aren't heart-wrenching at all.
Hundreds of thousands of years from now, that fact will not have changed. Remind me to say those words at my wedding.
All worlds have been saved, and even Nastasia, who was killed earlier by Dementia.
You know, I was gonna say that I would love to see these guys in a relationship if they think this is like timeless romance.
But yeah.
Even then, she starts bawling her eyes out.
But I guess that's exactly what's gonna happen.
Yeah, if these people ever, you know, get married, you know, the words he's going to say on the altars, you know, well, hold on, let me get out my my transcript of every line written in Super Paper Mario.
That doesn't change the fact that it's still
allow me to quote Count Black.
Now I just need, how long a pause is this many ellipses? There's a lot.
Yeah. Man, I hope Dementio doesn't, like, ruin my wedding or something.